Hi guys, welcome to Netcode-Hub channel. Imagine this, you are working on a simple inventory management system in .NET 9 or even in .NET as a whole. A user updates the stock level and simultaneously adds a new supplier. Everything seems fine until you notice an issue. Only half the changes were saved. The stock was updated, but the supplier wasn't added. Now your data is inconsistent and you are left wondering what went wrong. This is exactly why the unit of work pattern is so important. Unit of work pattern ensures that all related changes to the database are treated as a single transaction. This means that if one part fails, everything is rolled back, ensuring your data remains consistent and reliable. So whether you are building a small application or scaling up, the unit of work pattern is your key to preventing data corruption and ensuring smooth data operations. So let's dive in and simplify our database interactions. When you check my project, which is created with .NET 9, that is a new one, I have a repository, two repositories created. And is it two or three? Yes, three. So you see from here, I have brand repository and with the categories and also product. Now all these are CRUD. When you check the repositories, I have the interfaces and I have the implementations created here. That is a brand, category, and product. And I've used them in the controller. As you can see, I inject the interface and I can directly use it in here in an endpoint. But look at one thing. If you check all the repositories that we have created implementations, you could see that here we are adding it. We get it from here. We get it by ID. That's fine. Now see what the operation is. We're going to add this, then we save. We're going to update it, then we save. We're going to delete it, then we save. Right? Now look at this, having the same thing applies to the category. We add, then we save. We do everything here and I receive. So we are saving it one by one. That's fine. If you are having a single implementation like this, it's fine. Part of, look at something. In case I have another repository or another controller. Now this controller coordinates or performs two services together simultaneously. Let's say I want to delete a specific ID from all the reports, category, brand, and product. Let's say I want to delete an ID from each of the tables. Now, the rule is saying that all of these should be deleted or it should not do anything at all. But when you're using this, let's see what will happen. Let's create, now let's maintain this one. Let's go to our interface or let's say our controller. And now let's create another controller. And now this controller, we can name it as multi-delete controller or any name at all. You want to delete the product, the category, and also the brand. Simultaneously, we are injecting the product repository. We are injecting the category repository. And now we are injecting the brand repository. So definitely these interfaces are going to have list of items in the database because I've run it and I've added a couple of items. So we're going to check, but maybe the specific ID that you want to pass it on, it might be that it could be found in the product. It cannot be found in the category or it cannot be found in the brand. Now in this case, when using this type, you know that here this is going to execute. Since it has its own save changes, it's going to execute. Now the next one will also execute. So it could be that one can fail, the two can make success, or two can fail and one can make success. Let's have a look. So we're going to run this project without unit of work. Now we have our endpoints ready. So let's see if we're trying to get brand. Now you see from you having brand 1 up to 10, right? So for category, we are having 1 up to 10 also. Let's check out for product. Now product start from 1 up to 13. So let's say if you try to delete ID 12. Now, when it gets to the product, yes, it can get deleted. But look at the category does not have ID of 12. Same applies to the brand. So in this case, when we are not using a unit of work, if we execute this product first, this product will get deleted. And nothing happens to this and that one. And what if in case you want to make it in a way that it should be success, or even if one fails, it should roll back, or it shouldn't save it. Let's go to this, multi-delete. Now let's pass in ID of 13. Before we hit on this execute, let's go and put breakpoint. So put breakpoint to the implementation brand here. You want to delete this, so hit on this. Now this repo is for product, so let's step over. Now you see product is found, so it's going to remove this product beautifully, and after that saving changes. Nice. Now this is done. It's going to the next one as category. Now let's see, it gets a product and product is not found, and you can see so product. Oh, no, category is not found. Now product has been deleted, but the category is not found. So the problem is here. Okay, so this will just go, since we use this now check to just keep it without giving any issue. Now go to the next one, and that is for the brand. The same thing applies to this. Brand is not found, so it's going to close it. Now you can see that here one succeeded, but the two failed. But still the process went through. Let's see how we can optimize this with the unit of work. Now let's minimize this. Let's create a unit of work. So now that we are done with the interface, it's going to save changes async. After that, we want to go in there and create its implementation. So let's make sure our interface starts with I unit of work. So we can know that here, there is an interface. So let's make sure we do the right thing. So you see that here we are implementing from the interface that we created. Aside from that, we also implement from this disposable. So we can dispose this context as soon as the instance is created and now used. We want to dispose it. Okay, so now that we have this, you need to go and register this interface with this implementation. So let's go and do that. So now that we are done with this, we can go ahead. We go to our multi-delete and let's inject this here and start using it. So you can see from here that we want to perform all these operations. Now, if all of these are true, because since this is going to be the last part, if all of these are true, that is where we want to save. We need to modify these interfaces. Let's modify them. So we see instead of adding save, we want to remove all these saves. All right, so you can see that we are done with that. We have removed all the save changes and we have moved that to the unit of work interface. And we call that, which is going to persist all the changes which have been made to the specific endpoint that we're going to call. So once you use it here, maybe you're thinking or you're asking yourself, where do we use? Because here we're going to add. If I want to add product, where can I make it persist? Yes, maybe you can do that in the controller. When you have a service, that is where we need to do it. But since I don't have any service for this, we can do that in the controller. So here, you can see we want to create. So under creating, this is going to add it. After adding, we can inject a unit of work in here. Okay, so when we check here, now we are done. So you can see from here, we have replaced all the unit of work, the save changes in the controller, and that is what we have here. So after the update is done, the operation is done, this is going to save the changes. So we want to focus on the multi-delete because that is where we execute concurrent operations together. And here, as you can see. Now, before that, when you run this project and check it out, we deleted ID of 13 from the product, but we could not find the same ID from the other service. But there was no issue. It was succeeded. So you can see from here, when we look at for product of ID of 13, we're not going to see 13 because we deleted that. So you don't have, it's up to 12, there's no 13. You see that? But when you check from this category or this brand and the category, we do not even have the ID of 13. So now you want to skip this. Now, when you go to the product again, you can see it ends up to 12. Now, 12 does not exist either in the category or the brand. And let's go and delete it. Before we do that, let's make sure you put a breakpoint and see. So here we have a breakpoint. Check it out. So multi-delete. Let's pass in the ID of 12. Now execute this. This is hit. So delete from product. Since we have 12, it's going to execute this. So it is there and I'm going to remove it. See, good. Now this is saved, right? It is marked as deleted, but it is not saved yet. Let's go to the next. So look at this. Now he is going to get it. And since it's not there, we must have an issue. Now look at. So we are saying that value cannot be null because this is not found. Well, look into the controller here. This tax or this line is not executed. Now we could not save that. We have an issue over here. Maybe we can handle this error by introducing DB context exceptions. So how do we handle this error? You know, we can handle this low level exception. So in this product, definitely here, you must make sure when you call this in the service, you must make sure that this is found before you can pass on to delete. But well, in our case, we can throw maybe DB exception, right? So maybe here, this is what we can do. We can check that if this is null, then throw this an exception. So here you can see we are throwing DB exception, which is coming from the EF call. So we are saying category not found. We can just grab same thing here. Then we go to the brand. And also do same as well. So you can see that here, this is what we're doing. Now, as soon as you introduce this unit of work, it helps you to execute all functions or all method operations simultaneously. And if one fails, then the others are not going to be persisted. So they're also going to fail. But you know something? All that we have spoken of using this unit of work, actually, this simple unit of work, it is not recommended for a complex project. Do you know the reason why? Check out this. It lacks repository management. It is tightly coupled to the entity framework call. And it doesn't handle transactions effectively. It also violates the single responsibility principle. If you want to see a next unit of work which solves this issue, then give a like to this video and I'll prepare another content on that. All right, I believe you've understood and you can now start integrating it of work, simple unit of work in your simple project. Thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe if you haven't done that. And also hit on the like button as well if you like or enjoy this video. Until next time, take care.